Hey, this video I'm going to show how to unwrap. Use the unwrap UVW tool. So first I'm going to start by making a pyramid in the top viewport. Just because simple objects like planes and stuff aren't good for doing this. Then we want to convert this by right clicking, convert to Edible Poly. You can also do it in the Modifiers tab. If you right click, you can go Edible Poly, Edible Mesh, and so on. Then what we want to do is we want to, depending on your shape of your object, I like to do the UVW map first and find that one that works for it. So this one I'm going to use a box. I'm going to make it fit. Then I will also add on top of that the unwrap UVW modifier, and then we go into edit. I like to go tools, pack UVWs. I like to change this to linear packing, normalize clusters, so on, and that's what it has. The reason why I chose the pyramid is because I actually have to do some editing to it. If I would have done a box, it would have just had a bunch of squares in here. Been six of them. But this one I actually have to do somewhat of an editing thing. So first thing I'm going to do is select element, and I like to do polygon. So that right there is that polygon. If I select on here, oh, something else is selected. What is it? I know it's not the whole thing. At least it shouldn't be. So we go down here. Oops. So let's see, there's that polygon. That polygon, that polygon. Oh, okay, I guess that's all of them. And then this right here is the underside. Well, I guess that's it. But if you wanted to, you could take this and you go tools, break, and you can take it and move it off to the side like so, and then you have, so take this one, tools, break, it over. Let's see, so that's that one, tools, break. Now each triangle of the pyramid is its own little entity. You can move them around, place them where you want them. And so on. You can rotate certain things, like I'll rotate this one. So it's like that, using different tools. Let's see this here, I need to move, I'm just going to move it away from the edge a little bit. This one here, I will rotate, I think I'll just move, Control Z to undo, move this right here, back up here. This, I'll just scale this one down just a hair so it doesn't overlap. And then in 3ds Max 8 there is a tool to render out your UVW template. I like to unselect seam edges and set this to 256 by 256. Render UVW template, and there you go. You can save this. Blah, period, PNG. I'll go optimize palette. Then you load up your thing in Photoshop. And good thing to do is work with layers. but I need to unlock this first. So we go to image and mode and change from index color to RGB color, and now you can unlock this by double clicking on that. You can remove that or just add a new layer on top. Then you just take your brush and start painting what you want on whatever things you have. And if you go over the line like this right here, it will cut it off in Photoshop or in the thing. So we'll save this for web and devices, PNG 24. Yeah, that works. We go blah-1 PNG. If you can't tell, I like to use PNGs. And we go in here to our texture material modifier thing. Defuse, add a bitmap. Okay. Stuff box. Add our map to it. Go back to parent, show in viewport, and apply it to our material or mesh. Then you can look at it. And that's it. Then you can follow through with your skinning to your whatever, and yeah, good luck with